Well, hi guys. Welcome to Footsteps and Tire Tracks. Have you ever done something really, really stupid when you're editing your videos? I've just done it.
We're Mark and V, and this is our adventures.
I have managed to delete an entire folder of video files through DaVinci Resolve, and I've deleted it permanently. Well, I'm going to show you how to recover it. First thing I'm going to do, the folder it was in, I'm just going to bring it from the other screen, was in this folder here. I've just been to a VW show called Dorset Volksfest, and you can see all the files I deleted accidentally. I went into the, I wanted to delete just four files and accidentally selected them all. Stupid thing, yes I know, but I'm gonna show you hopefully how to recover them. So if it happens to you, you'll be able to do it as well. So the first thing we need to do, I'm just gonna minimize that. The first thing you need to do is you need to download a bit of free software. Okay, so the first thing we need to do is we need to go to the CCleaner website. As you can see here, ccleaner.com/ccleaner/download. And we only need the free version. So just select free version. I mean, if you want to buy the full version, please do. It does have some more features, but for what we're going to do, we're just going to need the free version. So click on download. Page and then you want to download. So we're going to save that file. We're not going to save it there though. We're going to save, we'll save it to our desktop for the moment. Click save, download the file, then literally just do the install. So we're going to do that now. So we've downloaded the program and we got it running. So I'll just bring it up. I'm going to show you in a minute how to use it. I started doing this before I thought about doing this video. So you can see it's actually searching a folder, and I have two options. The first option is to actually search the folder on the computer where the files were, and if I fail, then I will go to the SD card where I cut and pasted the files onto my computer. One way or another, I'm gonna show you how to recover this, no pun intended, and successfully carry on with the project. Well, okay, so we've stopped scanning and you can see that it's found the files I've been looking for. Which has been really, really lucky, but like I said, it normally is very successful, and this is free software as well. So I'm going to select all the files I want. Now, amazingly, the three I didn't want are the three. That's the three I thought I deleted, somehow deleted all of them. Mistake, it's an easy mistake, but you need to know how to get yourself out of trouble when you can. Right, so what we're going to do is we're going to select the files we want, and they're going to put them back into the folder. So we're going to hit recover and select the folder for recovery. So we're going to go back into our folder. Well, this is an interesting thing, isn't it? Do we want to recover it to the same folder? We won't do for the minute. What we're going to do is we're going to actually recover it to a different location. So we're gonna do apologize for the builder. We're gonna recover to a different location. So I'm gonna recover to that folder there. So we'll just put them in there and we'll say okay. So now we'll run that. That'll be hopefully very quick. I'll speed this process up because it's boring watching it recover. And I will show you in a minute how to use the program if you need to recover something. What we'll do is we'll look at the SD card that I had as well. So I was lucky in the respect that I had two options, because it would have been on the SD card and it would have been in the folder. So there were two scenarios. So I'm hoping that everything we want is going to be there. Now, once it's recovered, it may not be there. So we may have to look at the SD card as well, which is not an issue. It just takes time. I think we'll stop this recording and we'll come back. You can see the folders are being, the files are being recovered. And once we've recovered them all, then we'll copy them back to the original file location. You know, I said copy, not cut, just to be on the safe side. And there we are. So we've successfully copied the files. So I'm actually going to close this program for the minute, but I will show you in a minute how to use that. So we are going to, let's just open one a minute just to make sure. Okay. That's not so good, is it? File may be corrupt. So we may have to recover from the SD card anyway. Let's try a different program a minute. Let's try open it with VLC. Okay, so looks like we got a total fail there. So what we're going to do is we are going to reopen the program and we're going to look to the SD card and hopefully we'll be successful there. So we still, as you can still see, we still got the issue there. So we're going to open the program. So here we are. It opens up with a wizard, so it makes it a lot easier. So next. I think we're going to say all files this time, because where we're going, it's it should only be video files anyway. So we're going to go to next. Now we know the location, it's actually on an SD card, so we're going to select that and then we're going to browse. And we're going to come down. And it's going to be on H, which is the SD card that's in there at the moment. Now if I was to, I'm just going to show you what is on H, just so we're fully aware. That's the folder it would have come from. You can see the LRF files are there, which I believe at the very worst we can rebuild the files from there. They're low resolution files, so it's not going to be as good, but we can use them. But we don't want to do that for the minute. So what we're going to do is I'm just going to put that to one side. We're going to say okay, that's the location we want to recover. So we'll say okay there. We'll hit the next. We're going to do a deep scan. This may bring up extra files, but I'd rather do extra files than files. And then we'll say start. And there, that's going to take quite a bit of time. But you can see there it's finding files already. And then we just got to hope this time they're not corrupt. So we'll come back once we've done all the scanning. Well, we're a little bit further into the scan of this SD card. And you can see there's over 11,400 files found so far. Well, the biggest issue I think we're going to have is the naming conventions on DJI Osmo Pocket cameras. Is the fact that they name the files the same every time, so we don't have, like we do 1 to 50 on this shoot and the next shoot we do 51 onwards, it just reverts back to 01 again. So that may be our biggest issue. However, I do know that if we look at the LDF file on the disk on the SD card, we have the low resolution files, so at the very very worst we can use them and recover our project to a point. Unfortunately this is the situation we're in, but let's see if we can recover these files. There's going to be a lot to scan through, so hopefully we will find the right ones. Okay, now you can see we moved on to the next stage, and you can see all the green files are good files and they can be recovered. So we're gonna literally come down through and deselect any red files. No point wasting any time on them. And amber files as well. I'll just literally go for all the green files and hope that the files we're looking for will be in amongst them. So that's all good files. So we're now gonna select recover. We're gonna go to that folder again we created, but we're gonna make a new folder in there. So we'll call this SD card. And we're gonna say okay to that. And now that is gonna start recovering the files. So we'll come back when that's all recovered. It's finished recovering the files, so we'll say okay to that. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to go into the folder and just see how lucky we've been or how unlucky we've been. So we'll just bring that over and we will go back to recovered and into an SD card. Now all the files are there. Let's just let them refresh. Are we going to be lucky enough? It looks like again. Try opening it with VLC. No, VLC is not going to work as well. Let's just come down through. We've got lots and lots of files. Ah, look at this at the bottom. These are the files I think we're looking for. Let's just go into one a minute. That's a photo. Well, actually, these are photos, but that is. Yes, look at that. So we have managed to find the files. So hopefully I'm going to be able to use that in this, because we just had some music, didn't we? Have I broken YouTube copyright? I don't know. Anyway, we've recovered it. So let's go back up and find all the files we think we require. And I think if I'm going to come down through, like I said, there's an issue with the naming structure on the Osmo Pocket. And I hope that's the Osmo Pocket 2 I have. I'm really hoping, and if they bring out an Osmo Pocket 3, that they sort that out, because it's so frustrating. On the Osmo Action 3, you can set up the naming convention and it works. So you don't have to worry about overwriting things. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna copy all these files. So you can see the process that we're gonna go through next. We don't need, and two at the bottom we don't need. So we're going to copy them, we're going to go back to the original folder and we're going to paste them in there. It's just going to take a little bit of time, but once we've pasted them in there, then we're going to go back to DaVinci Resolve, which you can see in behind, and we're going to try and relink the files. The only thing I haven't got is the music files, but I can re-download them because I've got the names. So I'll go back to Epidemic Sound, coincidentally, where I download my music from, and we'll install them as well. But let's copy these files across and show you the relinking, and we've been very, very successful. Now, had this not worked, there is also a file called an LDF file in the SD card folder, and I'm going to show you how to use that in a minute. we've just copied them across, so let's move that out of the way a minute. Let's move that one out of the way, and move that one out of the way. So we're back in DaVinci Resolve, and we're just gonna click on relink. So we're gonna relink these files first of all. And I'm hoping that we'll get requested to look where in a minute. Now, there we are. So we're gonna go into D, into DVF. Well, that is very strange because I can actually see them in there. Okay, so two clips weren't found. But we'll come out of that and you can see. I'm just gonna scroll through that very quickly and you can see the files that I'd lost appear to be there. So I am really, really happy with that. And the last thing I said about was the low definition files that can be found at the same time if the worst happens. So I'm gonna go back into the SD card. You can see there I'm in the SD card and low resolution file. So I'm just gonna pick on that one and we wanna open it with a program that we know is gonna work. So we're gonna open it with VLC. So I'm gonna click open with, look at more apps, and we're gonna come down to VLC. VLC is such a great program. And there we are. And there you are. That is how you recover your files should you be as stupid as I was and delete them. I really hope that has helped you guys. If you've deleted your files and managed to recover them, if you've lost your files, you need to relink them, hopefully this has done something for you. So I'm gonna say, whew, saved by the bell even. Really, really panicked then. So I've got a little bit of work to do yet. I've still gotta download the music files and I've gotta recopy the iPhone files, but they're both on the iPhone. So the iPhone files are on the iPhone so I can get them again. And the music files are on Epidemic Sound. I'm babbling a bit, ain't I? Anyway, I'm so chuffed that I found them. Hopefully you found this video really useful. Thanks for watching, guys. If you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, please do. We really appreciate it. And we'll see you in the next video, which will be this one that I'm actually working on. See you later, guys.